He's coming.
He will.
Nice.
After his freshman year at Butler.
That's what's up.
So, very good young man. He'll be here. Epic 7 guy. Number 4 was the Cali War Players.
Yeah.
Who joined the show all the way from California. That was our last show we did before we hooked up with UClick TV.
That's at the
in the exclusive studio.
The Cali War? I thought we did Cali War at the Harris.
Yeah, the exclusive studio.
Exclusive studio. Yeah.
Exclusive studio.
At the Harris.
Yeah.
That was good.
Number 3 is Will Gordon of Charmin Chinese Baseball, who was supposed to make it today, but unfortunately had something come up at the last minute.
Yeah, that's a good show. Yeah.
Show number 1, the very first show we ever did. We didn't even really give it a title. We just called it Show 1.
That's the first. Is that number 1?
That's number 2. That's number 2.
Oh. Hey, I tuned into it.
Yeah,
and
you did.
And now he's on the show.
I downloaded it, and now I'm on the show.
And now he's here. And then the number 1 episode of all time is Justin Hoover, talking ball with Coach Justin Hoover.
Is he coming?
Football coach at Charmin Chinese. Now he's out of town as well. So
okay.
We have several people that are going to be here that are in our top 10 and several people that are not going to make it. But what are your memories, Austin, about doing that show with Coach Hoover? In the office, coach's office at Charlotte Mission East.
The deal about doing the show, you know what's funny about what he's doing right now?
He's reminiscing.
No, it ain't reminiscing.
Down memory bliss.
He's kissing up a little bit. He's kissing up. He's saying, man, it's the greatest show of all time.
I'm not saying it's the greatest show of all time. I say it's the most downloaded.
He say it is most downloaded. No, Coach Hoover's one of those guys that, hey, there we go. What's up?
Yeah, Ron Rodriguez just walked in.
He's one of those guys. He's one
big
of those
time
guys.
Guest.
When you talk to him about football, or you talk to him about, anything related to football, or just, he is 100% professional, and you can tell he's super smart when it comes to the knowledge of the game, and so that's having him on was pretty cool. I just remember getting in talking to him when I was feeling pretty good.
Yeah, it was good. It was a good one. Coach Hoover. Another guy unable to make it today is our wide receivers coach at Charmin Chinese, Andrew Gagnon. Another good show that we did again there in the office at Charmin Chinese. We started this thing literally, guys, recording on my phone in your dining room.
Hey, Gary, what's that?
Easy. That's sick. That's pay dirt, baby.
Hey, yeah.
That just means Jason Garrett's out of town even faster.
I got Eagles +1.5. I'm feeling pretty good right now.
So, and now here we are doing a live show right here at the Well. So, Andrew Gannon. Another one we did was Coach Ray Caldwell, former NCAA football coach out there down in Georgia. We called him on the phone
and had him
on the show. Yeah. That was another good one.
You know, it's funny when you talk to these guys, you can always tell, I don't know, it's like the way they talk or experience talking, but you always can tell the guys that have a lot of football knowledge or a lot of football experience. And they come across as when they start talking about some of the things they've done or whatever, it's just like, man, these guys know what they're talking about. And you feel kind of, I don't say blessed, but you do kind of feel talking to them and just like make anything I can get from you is just, it's great. So. We had a lot of good guests on the show. So
knowledge is knowledge.
We have, we have had a lot of good guests, and we're gonna try today, Moal. We talked about DJ Patel a little bit earlier.
Yeah, he's one of the faves.
Yep, he's been on a few times.
I'm a little biased towards that guy.
Yep, Coach Gordon. We mentioned him. You know, unfortunately, he won't be able to make it again. He had something come up at the last minute, but we'll talk more about him later. Dan Vaughn and Frank White, both guys that are, associated with the Kansas City T-Bones, who are still in existence and released their schedule this week, Kansas City T-Bones. So we'll be back out there probably in the springtime doing some games live. We're doing a show live out at the T-Bone Stadium. So hopefully if you're listening to this right now, you can make it out for the T-Bones.
You know, I kind of missed out. I had the... I had a GoFundMe set up to try to purchase that team. I don't think I got. I'm talking. What's going on? No,
hey, watch out.
A moment. Oh.
He doesn't want to wait.
I had a GoFundMe set up to buy the T-bones. I don't think I got any donations except for what I donated to myself.
Yeah.
But I'm glad someone else actually picked the team up. So I was thinking, man, there ain't no way that no one buys it, right?
Yeah.
And so I'm glad someone's got it, and I actually don't remember who it is.
Yeah, hashtag fun well done is still going, though.
Hashtag fun well done is still going, so we'll be out there for the T-bones. Hopefully they keep that that dollar beer night going or whatever it is.
Yeah.
We
like that. So Dan Bowen, who's the voice of the T-bones, and then Frank White, a Kansas City legend, who is the first base coach of the Kansas City T-bones. So that was an excellent deal. You know, have him on. Trevor Moss of Walk-Off Wood Bats is another one.
Yeah.
You know, that we've had on through them. Coach Justin Hoffman and Deontay Pinnell of Peru State University.
Yeah.
A little bit about Peru State. You know, their head coach just retired, Coach Schneider. And so they are currently seeking a head coach. Maybe somebody out there listening to this will want to apply for that and try to possibly be the next head coach at Peru State University. Up there in Nebraska.
Yeah, I'd never want to apply there.
Wouldn't say that, man. I'm a friend of the show. Way to just get on the bus there, Tyler.
Have you ever been to Peru State?
I have not.
Oh, no, but he knows about the spot.
Have you ever been to Peru, Nebraska?
Oh, so
I have not.
So
they said it's a super small town.
Real quick, just a little background before former guests get really angry with you. It's about this is an Iowa-Nebraska thing.
Well, yeah, no, it's nothing personal. It's nothing personal.
It might be.
Peru State is it's an institution. It's good. It's great. Higher education is good.
I do.
But my personal viewings on it is that, well, we don't have to go there. It's okay.
Yeah. Take it easy on Nebraska.
Hey,
go Big Red, right?
Don't say that.
Oh, damn, don't say that.
Yeah.
Moving on there before we get in more trouble.
Sorry.
I like it.
I'm sorry if I offended someone.
Yeah, Drew Steffen.
That's just a hot take. I'm sorry.
Our golf expert, resident golf expert, ooh, Drew Steffen. He will not be in the house today. He's currently in Florida enjoying the sunshine. So he golfing? Said he'd rather be in Florida. Yeah, he is golfing actually right now.
Is he golfing for a purpose or just golfing for
just
fun?
Just golfing for fun.
I like that. Hey, I'll tell you what. Gary's going through. He's scrambling right now because he wants us to avoid talking about what's going on with this game right now.
I love it. It just means that's one
how
less
do you
game.
Love it?
That's one less game I got to watch Jason Garrett coach, man.
So you're a long-term fan. You're like, man, whatever's good for the long term, I'm good.
Yes, and so the long term is to get that bum out of town.
Dude, I'm telling you.
Hey, here we go. Win with this guy.
Here we go. They fire Jason Garrett. Cowboys end up winning like three games next year.
Nah.
Maybe.
I think the only chance Cowboys are going to the Super Bowl is on Madden.
Whatever.
I thought you were going to say something else.
No.
I was going to say maybe get rid of don't pay Dak.
This year.
Yeah,
this year.
I would get rid of Dak, too.
I would franchise him.
I don't know, man.
Honestly.
Oh, actually, paying. You know, the issue was... Look at that.
Oh, Arizona
Drake.
And Seattle.
Drake. That's the Kid Miami running back.
Drake.
They got him from Miami. Yeah. Arizona just scored a touchdown, and the Chiefs just got a dude from Arizona.
Ooh.
Got dropped on waivers. Terrell Suggs picked up
you
by the Chiefs.
You may know that name. You may know that name.
Might know that name. The dude's Hall of Famer.
Yeah.
Yeah, he'll be Hall of Famer. He's like 17 years. 17 years?
Something like,
So he's playing. I don't think he's starting, but he's playing tonight for the Chiefs. What are your thoughts on Terrell Suggs?
I think that was a genius pickup, especially after they lost their defensive end.
Okafor,
yeah, yep. That pectoral's tear. I think it's a strong pickup. I think Suggs is going to come in. I think he's going to help out a lot because he wasn't a bad player in Arizona. I don't know why they dropped him.
What they did was they actually had – I think they actually could save – well, so they could save a little money –
yeah,
by not having him there,
money.
And
I think he wanted to go back to Baltimore and retire as a Raven.
I think
that was part of the.
That was part of it.
That was the
so
big
part of the,
thing.
Yeah,
the
report I saw was that when he got put on waivers, he was really hoping the Ravens were going to pick him up on waivers, and the Chiefs picked him up. And actually, the sentiment was that he was going to retire if the Ravens didn't pick him up, but because the Chiefs picked him up, potential Super Bowl contender. Bing, bang, bam, he's going to play for us.
Yeah.
And he's actually pretty pumped. He's got
yeah.
Another thing that helps, too, is he has a relationship with Spags. because I think Spags coached in Baltimore for a few seasons. On a really good defensive coaching staff.
That defense
is pretty sick.
That defense has come too, and now you're going to see. I think you're going to see them take the next step with Suggs.
In the last 4 weeks, and I'm trying not to be like a super homer.
Oh no, it's okay.
But in the last 4 weeks, the Chiefs' defense is like skyrocketed to top right. The problem is you played in something like. The problem is we played. We played Derek Carr. We played Phillip Rivers. We played
Phillip Rivers, is a Hall of Famer.
Drew Locke, and so Phillip Rivers is a Hall of Famer. But the deal is, we played quarterbacks that are kind of like, yeah. And then we get another one tonight, Trubisky, right? Should be the same story. I mean, literally, I think the Chiefs are going to give up maybe 10 to the Bears.
As long as Travis Kelce gets a few touchdowns, I don't care what happens.
A few?
Yeah,
he's probably getting like one. Is he getting two?
Two.
I'm hoping.
We can all hope for two.
Actually, I think it's going to get. I think Mahomes will have three touchdowns.
Speaking of which, Travis Kelce, he's breaking records himself.
What record did he break last week?
Was it consecutive 1,000-yard seasons for a tight end?
You are correct.
Yeah.
Wow.
Man.
Big record.
That is a big
record. He's a great tight end.
Yeah. He's amazing.
He really is really good. When you match him up against a lot of the other guys that have come along, the deal that makes Kelce better than Gronkowski is that he doesn't get hurt.
Yeah.
Kelsey's hurt in his – I think Kelce got hurt in his rookie year.
I think Kelce that was it. Play through his injuries a little bit better, too.
Play through the injuries a little bit better. Gronk's big guy, a little bit of a softie.
Yeah.
Took a year off, maybe come back next year. We'll see. But Kelce's a better tight end. I'll take him over anybody. The only guy that comes close is probably Kittle.
I think
San Francisco.
That's the Iowa boy right there.
Ah, come on. Yeah. All the time, Iowa.
Iowa.
Hates Nebraska.
Tony Glass and myself were talking about that last night as we were watching that game and watching Kittle just destroy that defense.
Dude, he's on another level.
Yeah.
Him and Kelce are the top two. And Andrews. Can't forget about Andrews from Baltimore. That guy can flat-out ball.
You know what's crazy? I feel like I love to hate on Baltimore just because I feel like they're going to try to block the Chiefs from getting the Super Bowl this year. So I'm not even gonna say he's that great. You know, maybe he's in the top 20. Yeah, I don't know.
Andrews?
I'm being a homer right now.
Yeah.
Okay. Thank you.
Yeah. Thank you.
So, should we take a short break and then come back with our guest. First guest?
Yeah.
Yeah, we can. Yeah. Okay. Who is the first guest?
I
don't know.
Should we roll a dice?
Grab a rando.
Yeah. We'll just we'll see who wants to come up.
Yeah.
And join us.
All right. Sounds good.
Many guests that are here. See who wants to go first.
Yeah. All right. That'll work.
So, yeah, we will be right back after a short break, and we'll be talking more sports.
Oh. Yeah! Astro. Yeah.
I'm Gary.
Tyler. My own? Come on,
there we go.
I'm Tyler.
And hello. We are joined right now. Austin is walking around in the crowd. He'll be back up here in a few minutes.
Yeah.
But we are joined right now by Coach William Harris, the head football coach at Van Horn High School.
Yep.
Also a several-time guest of our show. The first guest we ever had on the show. So, Coach, how you doing today?
Good. How you got?
Oh man, we're doing great.
Here with you guys.
There we go. Now you're on.
All right, am I good?
Yeah.
Yeah, I hear that. My bad. Yeah. So glad to be here. Glad to be here with you guys.
Yeah.
It's congratulations, 100.
We're really happy you're here.
Yeah. Yeah.
Like you walked in the door like, yo, what's up, man? You've been on the show how many times? Is this three or four?
I want to say this is three. Is it four?
Might be four.
I can look. I got the list here.
I got all the numbers.
My guess is three.
You guys talk while I pull this up. So we're not just
I think
here.
I was the last one to see him, though. I went for the game of the week.
Oh yeah.
I think you're right. Yeah, because we talked to you before the season.
Tough game. That was a tough game.
It was. We didn't play well, yeah.
All right. Give us a recap of the season. Let's go.
We were 5-5 this year. Disappointing year, in my opinion. We battled through some injuries. We had some guys we lost in the first week, and we didn't get back to the playoffs. And it kind of was the theme through our season is we had a few injuries here and there that bit us in the butt in some games. So But overall, we fought early, but we let some things slip, and we didn't play very well defensively sometimes. So we struggled a little bit this year.
All right, Gary, what was the verdict on how many times he's been?
This is his fourth appearance.
I thought this is four.
Yeah,
right.
This is four.
He's been on the show the most, more than anybody, right?
Yeah, more than anyone.
Look at the record holder right here.
Midwest Mike's record holder.
Right, I appreciate
right here.
I appreciate that. Thanks.